and you are here. Most of all, as we always want you to know, that you are an asset and never a liability. And I'll be right back. I want to deal with something for a few moments on Gwen Berry of the Olympic team. She did not medal, and it's something that really disturbed me, but I'm not going to let it, because I understand that people have the right to their own opinion and how they feel in this country. There are a lot of people who were throwing things at her, and their narrative suggests that she goes back to Africa, or if you don't like being on the Olympic team, won't you quit? We don't need you anyway. You're a nobody. You're nothing. You're ugly. You look like a baboon. So many things that I heard, but I want to say this. You're entitled to type what you want in the room. You're entitled to say what you want. But to demean someone for just caring about themselves, I feel personally, is idiotic. And it's only those who have captured the sense of low self-esteem who always attack those who feel good in their own skin. This is not a racial issue. This is just about someone using her Fifth Amendment and her ability to talk and speak about what disturbs her. What disturbs you, as I said, you have the right to say it in our channel and in our room. We won't delete it and we won't get rid of it. If it's been deleted, it's been by someone that I'm not in control. Matter of fact, I'm going to take control of it. I'm going to get out rid of all the moderators because things keep being deleted. I'm going to keep one or two. But watch this. She tried her best, but there was a duality in her purpose for the Olympics. One was to medal, and the other was to protest. The Olympic Committee, based on an Arkansas governor, almost wanted to put her out, because they raised so much noise because they felt that her protest was defiance. And if she did not like what was going on when they played the national anthem with the word from slavery, that she could quit. Well, lo and behold, they never played the song until she took the platform. Then they played it. Every other time, the song was not played. So it was like someone almost on purpose knew that she was going to protest and made sure that she heard the words to that song. So she has a right to feel what she feels. Why is there a problem? She's the only one, and in my opinion, I feel that's what Sha'Carri Richardson was also banned by the use of marijuana, because they knew she was going to protest also. What's the problem? I'm gonna say, like Martin said, what the problem is, if these young women want to protest and stand on their understanding of what civil justice is, why not? Like she said, she earned the right to wear that uniform. If she's been a decent citizen, matter of fact, a good citizen, does not cause problems, does not cause issues. Oh, I know, as in my thumbnail, you don't want the world looking. You want it just to be hush-hush and quiet. I remember that in the 60s, 100%. We don't want the world to know, so let's send individuals down to the South so we can stop the ruckus. I believe everyone has a right to free speech and entitlement. If you have deserved it, if you are a citizen, yes, you do. Big J in no way is saying that individuals don't have a right to say what they please about her. Yes, they do. But again, she has the right to voice how she felt about that song playing. So when she turned her back to the flag and to that song, it had nothing to do with America. It had something to do with the disrespect of that song. How long will we be held in mental bondage, or do we have to hear about slave terms? My best friends are Caucasian, Latino, every race under the rainbow. That's not an issue for us or many today. It's just why, when she decided to do what she did, only at that point, it was never premeditated or planned, only when she heard the words of that song, why is it an issue? Why do you have a problem with it? Why did it disturb your spirit? Why did you leave negative comments? Why did somebody call her B-I-T-C-H? And I won't say the other things before I delete it. That was unnecessary, completely. We all have a right to live in our skin. If she wants to be masculine, that's her business. If she wants to look defining because she lifts weights, that's her business. It's none of mine. My job is with the media is to come on and present you information, a narrative to where you can make a conclusion based on her ability as an athlete, not as a protester. That's personal. She didn't meddle. Okay, we accept it. We receive it. But she gave it her all at that age. Come on. America, we can do better than that. Now, when we get these NBA players who make you and who entertain, nobody says a word. So I guess if it's not entertaining, you're not interested in it. And when I say you, that goes for anyone who feels that she was wrong in expressing herself. Have we gone backwards? President Trump was just allowed to express himself to the point to where Twitter had to shut him down, to the point to where Facebook had to shut him down. Now he's trying to establish his own social media network because his comments and his points were off topic 90% of the time. So what am I saying? I'm saying allow those who feel harmed, threatened, hurt, shamed by certain things in this country, allow them to be themselves as we all try to reach a different place in life, to where we all try to reach an understanding that we are all God's children. Until we all come together in the unity of peace and the bond of love, of uplifting each other, because we all have something valuable to give. What am I saying? Let's be better than we were 20 years ago. Let's be better than we were 400 years ago. Let's be better than we were 10 years ago, 5 years ago. Change begins with us. And if you're going to change, it starts internally. And then it spreads to everyone who you are associated with. I heard someone tell me a great quote one time, and you know I love quotes. It said, "Don't tell me who you are. Show me who you hang around, and I'll tell you who you are." If you say that you are a doctor and I see you hanging around nurses, most times you are a nurse who's claiming to be a doctor. If you say that you are an NFL player, but 90% of the time you are around NBA players, there's something that shows me that you possibly are an NBA player. If you say that you represent eagles, you represent eagles and you soar or hang with turkeys, Houston, we have a problem. So don't tell me who you are. Show me who and I you hang around, and I'll identify who you are. I just want to say thank you for being on with Big J. Those who are part of our renowned podcast in 49 states, we appreciate you. In a couple of hours, everything will be uploaded. We got kind of behind today, but we thank God for what is going on here at Big J. Let's Talk. Also, we want to thank those who do and have subscribed to our YouTube channel. You are amazing. Also, I've been forgetting this, and I definitely want to apologize. We have over 200,000 viewers on our blog. We want to say thank you. Those who have come over to YouTube, I know you've let me know by some of the things that you leave in the comments. We want to say thank you. Thank you for sharing and clicking those ads on our blog. We really appreciate you. Thank you for turning our business around in a direction that maybe in a few years it would be something that's positive, that can reach beyond and help more people. See, that's what it's about, reaching beyond and helping more people. So we want to say thank you again. We want to give a shout out to Kwame Brown for the shoe drive that they're having and passing out shoes. Peace and blessings to that. Every effort that's being made by content creators, we salute you. And you know what I'm going to say right here. I hear y'all. I hear you. Yep. Be the best. And the best you will become. Who going to say it? Yeah.